Hi everyone! Welcome back to IntegralCalc.com. Today we're going to be using the gradient vector to find the equation of the tangent plane to this function here. We've been given the function x to the fourth plus xy plus y squared equals 19. The first thing we want to do is get all parts of that function onto one side of the equation. So we're going to convert this to f of xy equals x to the fourth plus xy plus y squared minus 19. So we just subtracted from 19 from both sides to get everything onto one side of the equation. So we've got this function f of xy, and we need to find the equation of the tangent plane at the point P, which is given to us as 2, negative 3. So in order to do that, the first thing that we're going to do is find the gradient vector of this function f of xy. Then we'll evaluate the gradient vector at the point P, 2, negative 3, and that'll give us the vector that is normal to the curve at the point P. Then we're going to use that vector, as well as the point P, to find the equation of the tangent plane. So like I said, the first thing we're going to do is find the gradient vector, and the way that we do that is by taking the partial derivatives of f with respect to both x and y. So let's go ahead and take our partial derivatives first. So the partial derivative of f with respect to x will be 4x cubed, and we'll just take it term by term. 4x cubed plus y, and then plus 0 minus 0. The reason that the partial derivative of xy with respect to x is just y is because if we took the derivative of x alone, right, the derivative of x with respect to x is just 1. So we'd end up with 1 times y, which of course is just y, and therefore our partial derivative is y. Since there's no x variable involved in the terms y squared or negative 19, the derivative of both of those is just 0. The derivative of partial derivative of f with respect to y, term by term, will be 0. There's no y variable involved in the term x to the fourth, so the derivative of that term is 0. The derivative of xy with respect to y will just be x. The derivative of y squared will be 2y, and the derivative of negative 19 will be 0. So we end up with x plus 2y. Now the gradient vector is denoted by this upside down triangle, f of xy, and it's just the two partial derivatives. So first the partial derivative with respect to x, which is 4x cubed plus y, comma partial derivative with respect to y, so x plus 2y. So that's our gradient vector, but we want to evaluate our gradient vector at the point that we're interested in, which is 2, negative 3. So instead of f of x comma y, we say f of 2 comma negative 3, and we plug in 2 for x and negative 3 for y. When we do that, we'll get 4 times 2 cubed is 8, plus y is actually going to be minus 3, and then we have 2 plus 2 times negative 3. And when we simplify that, we'll get 32 minus 3 is 29, comma 2 plus 2 times negative 3. 2 times negative 3 is 6. 2 plus a negative 6 is going to be negative 4. So this here, 29 comma negative 4, is the vector that's normal to the curve at the point P. What we really care about is that this is basically represented here as A comma B. And the reason I write it that way is because we now have all the information we need to find the equation of the tangent plane. The formula for that is going to be A times x minus x sub 0 plus B times y minus y sub 0. And if you had a third variable, as you often will when you're dealing with gradient vectors, if you had a comma b comma c here, you could say plus c times z minus z sub 0. But in this case, we only have a and b, so that's all we're worried about. So, and then we set that equal to 0. This is going to give us the equation of our tangent plane. So obviously we'll take a and b, and then x sub 0 and y sub 0 are going to come from our point P as positive 2 and negative 3 respectively. So we already know that A is 29 here. So we'll say 29 times, and we leave this x and y in the equation as they are. So x minus our x-coordinate here of our point P, which is 2, plus B. Well, B is a negative 4, so we're actually going to get minus 4 times y minus y sub 0. Since we have a negative 3 for y sub 0, and we have this negative sign here, we've got a double negative, so we're going to end up with y plus 3. And then that's all going to be equal to 0. We could leave this just like it is, but it's probably cleaner to simplify. So we're going to multiply these out. We'll get 29x minus 58 minus 4y minus 12 equals 0. And when we reorder these terms, we'll do the x term first. We'll get 29x minus 4y, and then we would get minus 58 minus 12, which would give us a negative 70, but we like to move that to the right side. So we'll add 70 to both sides and end up with a positive 70 over here on the right. And this is our final answer. This is the equation of the tangent plane at the point 2, negative 3. 29x minus 4y equals 70. So that's it. That's our final answer. I hope this video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!